Is there anyone here who has not participated in a gong tourney before? So these gongs and instruments move a lot of energy, and sometimes that brings things up emotionally, physically. The invitation is to find your breath if that happens. If it becomes too much, you can always get up and quietly leave, but that shouldn't be an issue. I've never seen anybody need to leave a gong journey. But muscles can move, toxins get released. We'll talk about what to do about that after. And for me, sometimes emotional things come up. So if tears or laughter or anything comes up, let it. It's all good. It's all yours. Yours and our morphogenic field we're about to create. So when Kaimi and I start, we share three breaths, and I start deep in my na'au and fill up as much as I can comfortably, easily, and slowly. Hold for the count of three or four, and then slowly, just as slowly, release. And sometimes I pull my belly in to like really fully expel all of the air that I can. And while we do that, I like to grow roots into Mama Gaia, just as a mental exercise to set up that energy transference so that if things do come up that are ready to be released, there's a really easy channel to allow them to release into. Because Mama Gaia can take them, and she does really well, and she can transmute things. Come on in. There's space up here. There's a couple spots still here. Yeah, and just as importantly, there's that egress of energy into Mama Gaia, but she also has a lot of healing, especially. I make up, here we are in the middle of summer solstice thing, that there's energy available for you to pick up for your own transformation and for the good of the planet. So we will go for about an hour. It'll get loud and it'll get quiet and it'll get loud and might get quiet. And then it'll get a little quieter for a few minutes. And then I'm going to play this rap drum for a few minutes. And then it'll get quiet, and I'm going to let that sit for a couple, 3 minutes. So when it does get quiet, just be with your breath, be with your body, feel what's up. I like to take a body scan before I start and just see where my body is. And then when the journey is over, scan again to see what differences might be. And sometimes those differences have clues into ways I can be healthy. Summer solstice.
So it's good to set an intention if you happen to have one. Or you can just set the intention of whatever is best for you at this time. You may manifest.
Yeah. One of my favorites is a prayer to the Creator to show me the next best step. Where should I put my foot next? That one is sometimes beneficial. Mm-hmm. So, shall we breathe? We'll see you on the other side.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
as this sound journey draws to a close. And the last vibrations waft into the ethers. The invitation is to find your breath. No need to change it, just become aware of where it is. And let it gently bring you back to the here and now. And as your awareness with your breath brings you back in, you might find that you want to move just a little bit. Maybe just your toes or fingers at first. Maybe a little rolling of the wrists or ankles. And maybe as your breaths continue, you might find that larger muscle groups really would like to just stretch a little. And over time, you may find that you want to sit up, and you may not, and that's okay. As I spoke at the beginning, these instruments move a lot of energy. Sometimes that energy movement can jostle loose toxins from your physical body, places where maybe you've stored energy or chemicals that your body no longer needs. And those just get loosened up sometimes, and so it's a really, really clever idea to drink a lot of water in the next few days to really give your body hydration so that it can move things out that no longer want to be in. Same holds true for your emotional body. The invitation is to water it as well. And for me, that looks like as much as possible surrounding myself by beautiful people, kindred spirits, people who will respect my emotional body, people who want the best for me. Please do drink some water before you get behind the wheel of a car. If it's comfortable and convenient for you, get your feet on the ground. Just have a little energy exchange with Mama. Ground out well. Especially if you have to drive to Kaneohe. I'm going to say goodbye to the YouTube and Facebook people. Thanks so much for joining us. Drink water.